Good morning, children.
Good morning, ma'am.
We were discussing sample question paper released by CBSE in the previous period. First, let us complete that. Okay. We reached up to question number. Anybody is remembering till where we reached? 45. Yes, correct. 45. So we'll continue with that. Now, question number 46. Two important RNA processing events lead to specialized N sequences in most human mRNAs. Dash at the 5 prime end, dash at the 3 prime end. At the 5 prime end, the most distinctive specialized end nucleotide dash is added, and a sequence of about 200 dash is added to the 3 prime end. So you have to fill in what will come in the first, second, third and fourth fill ups and find out the correct option. If anybody is ready, you can tell me. At the 5 prime end, what is the process? About the processing events they have asked. See, initiator codon, that is not a processing event. Tell me, Nandana?
Gapping.
Yes, C is the correct option. C is the correct option. Capping at the 5 prime end. And at the 3 prime end, tailing. Tailing means what? A polyadenylate residue is added. So here at the 3 prime end, it is polyadenylation. And at the 5 prime end, what is added? Methyl guanosine phosphate. It is given, no? In your book, it is given methyl guanosine phosphate is added over there. And at the 3 prime end, polyadenylate residues, 200. About 200 of them are added. So the correct option is C. Shafi, may God bless you. What happened? Sneezing? Not bad? Okay. What are mini satellites? Next question. What are mini satellites? What could be the correct option? Vidur? VNTR is a mini satellite. So what will be the correct option? Vidur?
Yes, ma'am.
Ingi Pingi Pongi, which is the correct one? Anyone else can answer? Let it be wrong. You make mistakes. These are not repetitive sequences. Aren't they repetitive? I told VNTR come under mini satellites. So VNTR means variable number tandem repeats. So these are repetitive sequences. Correct option is C. They are short known coding. See, repetitive sequences, you know that mini satellites are repetitive sequences. But here, two places it is coming as a repetitive region. Okay. Here it is mentioned as coding. Here it is mentioned as known coding. And you know they are coding or non-coding? Hello?
Non-coding.
Coding. So correct option is C. Correct option is C. They are non-coding at the same time. They are repetitive sequences forming a large portion of eukaryotic genome. Now, question number 48. There was a mix-up at the hospital after a fire accident in the nursery division. And the children got interchanged. Or a couple is unable to find their children. So, with the help of DNA fingerprinting, they are going to find their solution for that. And from this DNA fingerprinting samples, identify their children. It can be one or more. And to be noted, the children will have 50% of the DNAs like their father, 50% like their mother, 50-50. Now, father, this is father's DNA. Mothers, and here child 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. You have to match them. You have to match these samples and then you have to identify which all children or which child belongs to them. Where the pattern is same, these two are to be matched. These two are to be matched. 50% like father, 50% like mother. Any guesses? You check, I will give you some time. I'll give you a few minutes to check that. All are doing now. Children, are you there? Anybody got the answer? Nobody is responding. Let it be wrong, children. You say whether you got it or not.
C.
C. Ah, correct. C is the correct answer. Now we'll match. Child one. See, this is matching with father. This is matching with mother. This is matching with mother. Again. So child one. Then child three. I'll take another color. Same as father. These two same as mother. Same as mother. Okay. So they are matching with their parents. So the correct answer is children one and three. Okay, now.
Ma'am.
Ah.
C. six also kind of resembles, right?
Six also. Just let me erase the whole thing. Anyway, such an option is not there, but still I will check. Okay, let's see. Child 6. See, this is not matching the first.
Ma'am, can the child not have something additional than the parents?
No, either like this variable number tandem repeats, either like father or mother. So this is different. No, it's not matching. This is also not matching. This one. Then this one. That could be. Then this three. This is okay, I think. So this one is not matching. This is not matching. This is matching, but this is not matching. So those which are not matching are also there. So this is not matching. This last one is not matching. So either it should be like father or mother. Okay.
Ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, could you check with child 4?
4. Yes, so this one and this is matching. Yes, I think this is matching with fathers. This is with mother. But this is not matching. See, it is a little below, I think. No, let me see. This goes above. Just a minute. I draw a straight line. So this is not exactly matching. This is fine. This is also fine. If needed, we can include this also, you know, except one, more or less are matching. But anyway, in that option, in the given option, 4 is not mentioned. That combination is not there. When 1 and 3, because 2 is not at all matching. So out of this, Nandana, you're hearing, no? So yes, out ma'am. Of the given options, what is possible is 1 and 3. But if you choose, for the sake of 4, if you're choosing 2 and 4, 2 is not matching. Okay, 2 is not at all matching. So then we can rule out that. 4 is ma'am. Also having similarity, as you said.
Ma'am, in child 3, the first 3 ones are not very matching, right?
Wait, let me check. Question number? What is the question number? Yes? 48. Child 3. Okay, child first 3. The first one is not matching, no? That is true. First one. One is okay. Okay. Three, did we check? Three, yes, did we check, children? Once again, I will just check three. So one is fine, then four is there, we saw, then third one. So this is not matching with anything. This is okay. This is okay. This is also okay. This is fine. This is fine. This is fine. This is fine. This is also there. This is also there. Except one.
Okay. One more doubt. Does the thickness matter? Like in the fifth, in the father's one.
Thickness matters.
First three have like a variable thickness than child one.
About four, fourth one, third one you're saying, no?
No, ma'am. Child one and the father's. You said they match. Right?
Ah, yes. So the gaps are there, you're saying.
Yes, ma'am.
Thickness matters. But not very... There that white space is more clearly seen. But they might have thought it is like similar ones. They might have maybe some printing that might have made the change, I think. Except one, the child three, majority it is matching. Only one is not matching. Out of the all the other combinations, I think the best possible option that we have is one and three. Two totally is not matching. So one and three, see, out of these four options, a little more suited for that, or the best suited for that is one and three. And in the scheme also, they have given it as option three. But in the answer key, mistakes are there. Question number that we are going to see, add some additional questions they have given. Their question number 23 and question number 59. So those options which they are given are wrong. So there can be a mistake in the question two, but with the limited things what we have got, best possible option is C. There can be errors. Maybe later we'll come to know about the mistakes in this paper also, because as I told you, question number 23 and 59, correct options are not there in the group, in the list. Okay. So this one we'll fix it as C from the options available. Okay. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Then we'll proceed. There can be mistakes. No doubt for that. I'll show you those two questions also where some mistakes are there in the options. Then we have yes, this one. Oh my God. Which cellular process is shown below? Here you can find a cellular process. Is it DNA replication, translation? B, C, and D are saying that it is translation, where the RNA is converted to proteins. Is it initiation, elongation, termination? Meenakshi, what is the correct option?
Elongation.
Elongation, correct. That is elongation. You can see the lengthening of the amino acids are being joined, and you can see one transfer RNA. After transferring the amino acid, it is being released, then more will come. So this is the elongation process. It has not reached the end of the messenger RNA. So this is elongation process. Now next is about origin of replication of DNA in E. coli is shown below. Identify the parts labeled as 1, 2, 3 and 4. 1, 2, 3 and 4. Which is the correct option? Yes. Correct option. Why nobody is saying anything? Is it difficult? One indicates what type of synthesis, children?
Continuous synthesis.
Continuous. Then if that is continuous, second one will be
discontinuous.
It's broken into Okazaki fragments, so that is discontinuous.
Indeed.
Third one will be third end. What is your doubt, children? Learned this topic only structure and replication.
It's D.
Three prime.
Option is D. That is, this is the 3' end, and 4 is the 5' end. Why? Why you wrote so, or why you are saying so? New strand can be synthesized only in which direction?
5' to 3'.
See, the arrow is going in this direction. Here also the arrow is in this direction. So it is 5' to 3'. So 4 is 5', 3 is 3'. Okay, after 1 they have given 4, then 2 there, 3. So when you are choosing the option also, you should be very careful. You have to correctly match the numbers with the options given. So you have to be very, very careful while reading the question and choosing the correct option. Transcription unit is represented in the diagram given below. You have to identify 1, 2, 3. Yes. Which is the process? Transcription. Which enzyme is involved, children? Steffi, which is the enzyme involved here?
DNA. DNA.
DNA polymerase is the enzyme for which process?
Translation.
Rejoice. What is the role of DNA polymerase to carry out which process?
Replication.
And which is the enzyme in transcription?
RNA polymerase.
Steffi, in DNA replication, a new DNA strand is being formed. So we need an enzyme which can polymerize DNA strand, or which can form a DNA strand. So DNA polymerase. But in transcription, what are we synthesizing? What is being formed, Steffi?
RNA.
So RNA is being polymerized, or RNA is being formed. Nucleotides are polymerized to form RNA. So the enzyme we need is RNA polymerase. So in transcription, RNA polymerase. In replication, DNA polymerase. Okay, now the first one is promoter site. You know that there is no confusion with that. So you have fixed this one, and this is also correct. But is it rho factor? This is also, see. Anyway, you might have chosen these A and C. You have reduced it to 2 options. Now you need to find out whether it is rho factor or sigma factor. Which is the initiation factor?
Sigma.
So correct option is? So which is the correct option, A or C?
C
is the correct option. Now moving on. I think all the questions are over. Now some additional questions are there. And these questions, some mistakes I found. That's why I didn't want to discuss it. See, let me see whether you are also feeling the same thing. See, 23rd question. Can you find out the answer for that? Question number 23rd. Which one of the following is an incorrect statement? Which one of the following is an incorrect statement? Gayatri? Which is incorrect? One by one, shall we see? first one. Is it correct or incorrect? First statement. It is an adapter molecule. Is transfer RNA an adapter molecule? Am I alone here?
Yes.
Ah, yes. That means I am alone here?
No.
Adapter molecule. Sorry, this one. Previously known as soluble RNA? Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, that is also correct. It's having a codon loop. Is it having a codon loop? Are you sleeping there? Is it a codon loop?
Yes, ma'am.
Codon or anticodon loop?
Anticodon.
So is it correct?
No.
Michael, is the third statement correct or wrong?
Wrong.
Wrong, because it is not a codon loop. It's an anticodon loop, which is complementary to the codon. So this is wrong. It is having an amino acid acceptor end to which it binds to amino acids. True or false? Children?
True.
Children, I told you, you make mistakes. You don't hesitate to make mistakes. If you don't speak out, how do I know? Let it be wrong. But you speak. It is non-specific for each amino acid. It is non-specific for amino acid. Is it? Or is it specific?
Specific.
Specific, no? How many transfer RNAs are there? How many are there? What is the number? How many codons are there, children?
64.
No, which all are functional except stop codons?
61.
Do we have transfer RNA for stop codons? No. So we have 61 transfer RNA for those 61 codons. So are they specific? The statement is true or false?
False.
Now you tell me, which are the incorrect statements here? 3 and 5. But do we have an option over here?
No.
That's what I said. This question, some mistakes are there. So anyway, there is no doubt for that. It is an adapter molecule. It was known as soluble RNA. Then it is having an amino acid acceptor end, and it is specific for each amino acid. So statements 3 and 5 are wrong. But if correct statements are asked, 1, 2, 4. C can be the correct option if they have asked for a correct statement. If it is a, which is a correct statement for a transfer RNA molecule, then you can go for C. 1, 2, and 4. Got it?
Ma'am.
Oh?
Ma'am, the amino acid is binding to the amino acid acceptor, right?
Ah, yes.
So, ma'am, it also has an amino acid acceptor end to which it binds to amino acid, but amino acid is binding to it, right?
Means anyhow, you are saying that amino acid is coming and attached to it. That's what?
Yes, ma'am.
Both ways. Anyway, it is getting attached to an amino acid. So, it is having anticodon loop at one end, and on the other end, it has got an amino acid acceptor end with which this binding is taking place. Okay. Anyhow, it is getting attached, no? Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Shall we proceed? Next one. So that I will find out if any corrections are, if I come to know, I will just discuss in the class. And one more question I had a doubt, that is question number 59. That also is a confusing question. The main reason for the presence of, okay, more are there. 58. On the ribosome, messenger RNA binds dash and the two sides in the dash for subsequent amino acids to bind to close enough, to be close enough to each other for the formation of a peptide bond. What is the correct option? First, it will be binding to what? First, it will be binding to what? Small or large? Remember the video, huh?
Small.
So C and D both are saying to the small unit. Now you have to choose between C and D. Second part. And two sides in the, on the ribosome, messenger RNA binds the small subunit and two sides in the dash for subsequent amino acids to bind to the large subunit. So large subunit is having, so here they have mentioned about two sides. I think in your textbook also only two sides are given. You know, EPA sides are there. So PA sides are given over there. So those two sides are present in the large subunit. So correct option is C. 59. The main reason for the presence of both a leading and lagging strand. So correct option I could not find in that. So that we will leave. Move to 60th question. In a cell, DNA transcription is halted or stopped or terminated when it is halted, children, is it when the polymerase falls off or when the end of DNA is reached or when a rho site is reached or when a stop codon is reached?
When a stop codon is reached.
Louder.
When a stop codon is reached.
Stop codon is only for a translation process. Here, transcription. Here we have terminator, no? Promoter site and terminator site. And what is the significance of rho factor? It's a termination factor. Stop codon is applicable in the case of translation. Here it is transcription. So C is the correct answer. When a rho site means the site of termination. Rho is a termination factor because only after it has happened, the RNA polymerase can fall off. Only when it comes to an end, RNA polymerase will fall off. And it is not till the end of DNA. It is till it reaches the terminator site. And stop codon is not applicable here. And the correct option is C, when a rho site is reached. Okay. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
So with that, we have completed the sample question paper from CBSE. Now we have to start with the different question banks. First, we'll start with Oswald's question bank. Okay, so we have 4 minutes. Shall we start? 12:40 is the time. No, don't want to start now. We covered only a few questions. No, I'll just show you one or two questions. And I had asked you to, oh, we have one more period, no? So it's okay. So we'll continue next class. We'll continue next class. I forgot that we have two periods. You have come prepared with questions, no? I had asked you to come prepared with a minimum two questions. So next class, I will ask you. So I'll take your attendance. Thank you, children. See you next period.